everybody. And I will see you on Sunday night. Whatsoever you do, whatsoever you do, to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me
playing the tambourines and dancing. She was an only child. He had neither son nor daughter besides her. When he saw her, he rent his garments and said, "Alas, daughter, you have struck me down and brought calamity upon me, for I have made a vow to the Lord, and I cannot retract it." She replied, "Father, you have made a vow to the Lord. Do with me as you have vowed, because the Lord has wrought vengeance on you from the enemies of the Ammonites." Then she said to her father, "Let me have this favor. Spare me for 2 months, that I may go off down the mountain to mourn my virginity with my companions." "Go," he replied, and he sent her away for 2 months. So she departed with her companions and mourned her virginity on the mountains. At the end of 2 months, she returned to her father, who did in turn as he had vowed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
Here I am,
Lord. I come to do your will.
Bless the man who makes the Lord his trust, who turns not to idolatry, or those who stray from falsehood. Sacrifice or oblation you wish not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Burnt offerings or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, "Behold, I come."
Here I am,
Lord, I come to do your will.
In the scripture scroll, it is prescribed for me to do your will. Oh my God, it is my delight, and your law is within my heart. I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know.
Here I am,
Lord, I come to your will.
Yes.
He saw a man there not dressed in white garments. He said to him, "My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?" But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, "Bind his hands and feet and cast him into the darkness, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Many are invited, but few are chosen." The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate the feast of St. John Eudes, who was born in Normandy, France, 1601. He was ordained priest at the age of 25, and for many years spent his preaching in spent himself preaching in various parishes. And then he was noted for reaching out to women who were, well, as the reflection says here, in order to ensure the training of good priests and to help women whose Christian virtue was endangered, he established several congregations. Well, those congregations, as I read his other book, was to reach out to some of these women who were on the fringe of society, who were prostitutes. And he even reached out to them. And he devoted, he was an ardent promoter of devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus and Mary. And he died in 1680. And in the book he wrote, St. John Eudes, The Life and Reign of Jesus and Christian Souls, he writes, "Our wish, our object, our chief preoccupation must be to form Jesus in ourselves, to make his spirit, his devotion, his affections, his desires, and his disposition live and reign there. All our religious exercises should be directed to this end. It is the work which God has given us to do unceasingly." And trusting in God's bountiful goodness, let us bring our petitions to him. For the leaders of the church, may the Holy Spirit grant them his gift of prudence to shepherd his flock well. Let us pray to the Lord. For civil authorities, may God give them the grace to carry out their duties with integrity and wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord. For single parents, may God bless them with the strength and support they need. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may God inspire us with a spirit of stewardship and furthering his kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord. For our students, our teachers, and our staff, as they begin a new school year, may they be kept healthy and free of the COVID-19 virus. Let us pray to the Lord. For Timothy, raise your family, who will remember in a special way at this Mass. Let us pray to the Lord. God our Father, we look to your mercy and generosity to obtain these and all our needs through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice of yours may be accepted to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of the blessed St. John Eudes, so that as you brought him glory, you may through these sacred mysteries grant to us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, and we, Father, Almighty and Eternal God, Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. John Eudes, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by the words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end, we acclaim. Body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered We have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, that all who have died in Jerusalem, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed St. Joseph and Spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Catherine of Alexandria, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son and Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him. O God, my Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray for the coming of the kingdom with the words that Jesus gives. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray for every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity, in accordance with your will, live and reign from now to the end.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
And let us offer each other a sign of Christ's presence. Thank you. come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. St. Joseph, watch over us and care for us, just as you care for the child Jesus. By him we come to know your Son, and so grow in strength and wisdom in the favor of God. Amen. And a reminder that tomorrow is our first school mass, which we will be here. It's a school event, so please wear your masks, because our children will be wearing their masks. And then, because the kids got their designated seating here, just kind of find yourself sitting in the back of church a little bit, okay? So the kids have room up front. We also have adoration today. Six in the Adoration Chapel. And we also have next week, Tuesday, our 55 Plus Club will gather for morning mass. As their intention, they will be praying for Catholic Turnborn, and then they pray the rosary, and then they go to the Pancake House for breakfast. Let us pray. May I partake at the heavenly table of Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast of Blessed St. John Eudes, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
In our recessional hymn is Whatsoever You Do, 789, verse 2. Whatsoever you do to the least of my people, that you do unto me. When I was homeless, you opened your door. When I